I didn't sing Kumar, Nirguni bhajans, before his illness. His illness, his prolonged illness. He came out of his illness with this treasure of Nirguni. And that is one of his unique contributions to the music, to bhajan and to culture. And Kumar himself told us that while he was lying bedridden, 6 years. 6 years in the life of a genius, you can imagine how many real years they could become. And all the time he was haunted by two things. One is the folk music around him, and the other is the bhajans. He used to go for walks, and then he used to come to some temple, used to find a very ordinary person singing those bhajans. And then he used to sit there, listen, but without disturbing that person. Later on, take down that composition and then work upon it. So there is a very strong coincidence here. Otherwise, and then this humility of Kumar is of later days. Young Kumar was so arrogant. But later, after his illness and everything, in fact, there is a theory that it was Kumar's personal as well as musical arrogance which caused the tuberculosis. That he was absolutely at such a high pitch in everything. You will find this in the book on Kumar written by his colleague and disciple, Pandharinath Kolhapuri. That people used to feel that, well, this guy is destroying himself by singing at such a high pitch, at so aggressively, everywhere, and at such fast tempo. Mercurial. So some people felt even then that this young talent should sit down, think about himself, think about life, but he did not. Finally, he was told by the doctors that music would be death, singing would be death, and he could not sing. If he wanted to sing, he might as well die. I think I have mentioned all this earlier also. And then he promises his first wife that don't worry, I will rise out of this and one day I will sing. I will not die unless I sing. So all these facts are there. And that's why I keep telling these young singers that you are too young to understand this Nirgun Bani. You don't know enough of life. Then that discussion generally degenerates into discussion of freedom of expression and artist freedom. Again, those guys are too young to understand what is exactly the freedom of the artist and how free an artist can really be. Nirguni requires, a spirituality requires either a born inclination towards it or a wide range of experience, and especially of the joys and sorrows.